Ever since I did a video about quiet luxury and I did those extensive, you know, video watching and everything, my YouTube homepage has been flooded with another concept: old money, new money, how to achieve the old money style, look, I don't know, manners and everything. And at first I was like, you know, ignoring it, not paying attention. But I got more and more, and I didn't know it's such a big thing, but now that I think more about it, it kind of makes sense, because you know, it's in line with that quiet luxury trend, only this is a lot worse because it actually targets the people, and it's less about fashion, style, look, and it's kind of deeper in my opinion. So I was like, I'm gonna make another video, and in this video I'm gonna be, you know, paying more attention to the psychological aspect of it. And in the other video, the quiet luxury, I kind of challenged the trend from fashion perspective and how it's not really anything to fall for, and not having anything added compared to like minimalism. But this one is a little bit different. So I mean, in this video I'm gonna be telling you about my own experience with people who are comfortable. I don't want to say old money, new money, but like people who have been comfortable for some time, and what I have learned so far and how different that is from what you see on the web. And like, you have to do this, you have to do that, people who are, you know, old money people act this way or that way. So if you like that, continue watching the video. You know, when I was doing that research on quiet luxury, I could give people the benefit of the doubt, and I could see that not everyone goes super deep in what that trend means, and you know, all the detail. A lot of people look at it and like, it's simple, it works, I like it, you know, I'm gonna be following it. I don't think many people are like, oh, I like the meaning behind that trend, and I definitely want to do that. I think people, when you tell them where it comes from and what are the underneath layers, they're like, you know, I'm gonna stick to minimalism, this is not aligned with my values or everything. So I can give people the benefit of the doubt. I don't judge people for following that trend. It can be just aesthetic. But when you're talking about old money and new money, it's a little bit different. I feel like you know where you're going and you're comfortable with that. So I kind of take it with a grain of salt when I hear old money and new money and everything related to that. Why I don't like it? Because of what it means. You know, at the beginning when I heard it quite often, I was like, you know what, I'm gonna give it the benefit of the doubt, I'm gonna go look it up in dictionaries and see, maybe there's more into it, maybe I'm not aware of the whole meaning. And no, I was right. You know, new money and old money. Old money basically means people who have inherited wealth and it's been going on for several generations. And new money, people who are first in the generation to achieve wealth and through their hard work and effort. So by solely looking at the definition, if you value old money over new money, you're basically valuing consumerism, people who have been given money no matter what, compared to people who've been through a lot to achieve that wealth despite not having all that accommodation and privilege of people who come with money. So respect wise I have no respect for this term, for this language. I think it's not okay to think that way. And it's funny, think about it, in like seven generations, that person who is making that money right now is going to be respected, the children are going to be respected for what the guy is doing now, and he's considered like, ew, new money. So very funny, and no respect, sorry. So this term is classist. If you consider yourself a woman of class, a man of class, and you use a term like this, you are denying yourself Because class doesn't start with fashion, style, and your look. Fashion, style, look, they are further in the line, and they are only useful when you are only visually exposed. They can help you only in that way. Like, for example, years ago with Instagram, that was like, it was only flooded with images. There was minimal caption, no videos. So at that time, maybe fashion and style would take you somewhere, but the moment you open your mouth, you are gonna talk your values, you're gonna, you know, show very clearly how you treat people, how you judge people, what you respect and what you don't. So maybe for 5 seconds fashion and style can do something for you, but they're not gonna be helpful, you know, if you can't have that class, that mannerism, and have the right values. Fashion and style won't do anything. People will look at you and be like, okay, I'm done with this person, and they just move away. So you can have, I don't think you can have that type of language, judgy language of, oh, new money, you know, calling people to kind of basically target their personality and what they have done in their life, and consider yourself a woman of class, a man of class. I have not seen people using that term. I'm saying this might be a culture thing, this might be a family thing. If I was a kid and I used that term, which we do in French, they have the term, in Persian we do have the term, it's like taze bedoran raside, that's what we say in Persian, which means new to the game. And if I use that term as a kid, I would be punished, you know, like a 4-year-old, 5-year-old, if I said that. Maybe a little bit older, you realize what it means. But like, if I said that, my parents would not be very happy. I probably wouldn't get any treat, or like wouldn't have any TV time. So very early on, at least I'm saying in my family, it was taught that you should not treat people like that, and you should not talk like that, and having that kind of tone is not okay. Even I feel like in general, you see people maybe gossiping a little bit here and there with people they're very, very close with, and they say, yeah, look at them, they're like new to the game or stuff like that. But they only do it with people they trust and they're comfortable with. They're not going to be shouting that out loud, because they know they're kind of be denying themselves if they use that kind of term. They're basically attacking themselves. Hopefully, you know, this might be a little bit of a difference between culture, but I think I have seen it here too, in America, and I think people are a lot more humble here. So I think it's very common. If you're American and you have like American background, you probably, you know, relate with that as well. So I don't know why it is very okay online to talk like that. Maybe it's not as okay as I think. I'm just being flooded with all of that content, but let me know. I'm actually pretty curious to know. TV rich is not real rich. You know, when you see rich people on a TV show, for example, The White Lotus and like Succession, you know, shows like that, that is not the full reality. You know, they are trying to make a point most of the time, and when they want to do that, first of all, they need to exaggerate. Second of all, they need to pinpoint problematic people. You know, not everyone is bad and not everyone is causing a problem. So they have to, you know, pinpoint on those people that are like very excessive, they're like too much and problematic, to kind of make it clear. Or like very dramatic, like Succession, like how things were all the time. You're like, oh, what's gonna happen in the next show? That's not the life of everyone, you know, on the everyday basis. And if it's not that dramatic, you're not gonna continue watching the show. So it works in the entertainment industry, and you see it in like, you know, reality TV show. I don't watch reality TV shows other than the cooking ones, but you know, that is the same concept. It works, and that's what you get. There's a problem in, you know, movies and shows are trying to make an impact. They put their focus on a problem and they exaggerate it, so me and you can clearly see the problem and understand the point. So the TV rich is not real rich. So don't make an assumption that, oh, this is how, you know, rich people are and this is how they act. No, there are a very small percentage that are like that, and definitely not the majority. Maybe not as small as I think overall, but definitely not the majority. You know, a lot of these content, a lot of this kind of judgment in talks comes from people who are new, and they're judging others who are kind of newer than them. So most of the time, you don't even see people that are considered old money even part of this game. This game is only among people who, first of all, care about this. You know, how long they have been having the money, and like they kind of want to be entered into that game, and then they have this kind of competition, I'm better than you, you know, I have more money, you know, the people who kind of are confident about who they are, what they have, and they don't need the reassurance about their wealth are not part of that game. They don't even play that game, you know, so it seems like a game between the new and the old. This is what I have seen. Less often I have seen people with that title of, you know, old money, especially people who are contributing to that wealth, to be playing that game. They're not even in the game. So don't even get caught into it. This is not a good game. This is a very cheap game, and you cannot win it. It's kind of like a gamble. You pour a lot into it, and at the end, you're left with nothing. So try not to care and be like those, not even play the game. Yeah, there are some people who are labeled old money, and they're very judgy, and they're not very nice. In my experience, what I have seen so far, those are people who are kind of receiving the money. They are not the source. They're not the people who kind of made the wealth, or they're, you know, adding to it. They're basically using it, and money is all they have. So, and they know that very perfectly, you know, clear. Maybe they act in a way that make you feel less of yourself, but they know that if they don't have the money, they don't have an upper hand, so they have to make that very clear that they have more money than you, and therefore the upper hand, because the insecurity is greater than you think. And yeah, what I have seen in my experience, they are not the source. They are more of the consumer than like the money generator and wealth generator. A good example, for example, for that can be Succession. When you look at the show, the children are 10 times more sassy, and like, you know, they're very judgy, and they treat people pretty poorly compared to the father who's actually, you know, creating that wealth. And that is very similar. Normally, the people related to that big source of wealth can be, you know, pretty unpleasant to deal with because of that insecurity and the fact that they know they're not contributing to anything, and they're consuming that wealth, and without that wealth they're not much. So don't let it get into you. If you see that type of behavior, don't let it get into you. It's not even about you, it's about them and their own insecurities. Just, you know, exit and not let it bother you. Just like, you know, that quiet luxury trend that they talk about, classic style and, you know, uniform and like blazer and, you know, suits and everything. That's not true. You know, they dress practical. And the reason they dress practical is because they don't try, most of them, especially people who work a lot, they contribute to that wealth. They don't, first of all, they don't have time like to be constantly shopping. Maybe people are related to them. Follow fashion very closely and everything, but people who are more in the source, they don't really have time to be constantly shopping, so they will buy something that they can wear for some time that is okay in the communities they are in the business and everything, and then again they have to change it again and buy some new clothes. It's not because fashion is bad or like It's cheap. No, it's not. Just because of the matter of time and the fact that they don't try to really impress people, confident in who they are and what they do, a big portion of them. And they follow fashion moderately. When I look online and I saw videos, they're normally talking about a very vintage style, old-fashioned look, and they're like, people with old money dress that way. Well, that's not true. First of all, it's not really okay to judge an old money just by looking at the royal families. It's just they have to follow a very strict guideline, and they have to dress. Every color means something. At this day, you have to wear that, and that's only a royal family-like guideline. People who have money are not royal, and they don't follow any of those guidelines. So you can't really, use photos of people from royal families and be okay, you see, this is how they dress. No, that's not correct. And second of all, a lot of people who have a lot of money, are old. And that makes a lot of sense. Normally, when you are in later in your life, you have, more money. And people normally dress based on their peak time in their life. It's very interesting. For example, in your 30 to like your 55, 60, your peak time, what is okay, what is in fashion, and what is considered stylish will kind of stick to you as you get older. So, for example, me and you, when we get older, we probably wear sneakers on a daily basis when we are probably in our, 80s, if we get there. Because right now, when we are in the peak of our time, these are okay. Sneakers are a lifestyle item. So you grow on with that mindset and you keep on doing the same way, pretty similar to what you were doing in your peak time. I talk about this in another video, but just get it that part. So, for example, if someone is 50 years older than me, their peak time is going to be different and their style is going to be more towards like the vintage look compared to me. So you can't judge it that way because it will change. And like when you reach that time, people with money will dress differently because of what was okay in their time. So I don't agree with the fact that they say they dress old school and they show you very, very vintage style. No, they follow fashion moderately, and the older you are, your style can be a little bit different because of your peak time. And that's the point. It's not because you have to buy like Ralph Lauren and polo dress shirts and everything like that to have that look. No, that's not correct. So yeah, that's what I think. That's what I have seen in my life, and hopefully it will help you to make a better, clear judgment. Share your experience with me. I'm very curious to read them, and I will see you in the next video.